longer. So we're going to set up like so. And kind of gently press your heels into the top of the chair just to lift your hips off the ground, maybe just an inch or two. We're going to hold it there. Full inhale, expanding those ribs all the way around. Hold it for a second or two. Let it all out through the mouth. Do you feel those abs? Do you feel those ribs come down and together? Repeat that 5 times. Here we go. Good. So that even gives you an idea of how long, you know, each breath cycle should take. You just did 5 there, that probably took a good 90 seconds or so. Alright, first up, I'm going to go to the core or band engaged dead bug. So if you don't have anywhere to anchor a band, any variation of that dead bug is fine. If you remember the wall press one we did, press your palms into the wall. As you exhale, extend one leg. It'll also help keep those ribs down and keep that good alignment. I'm just using a band, which we've done before. It essentially achieves the same thing. So if you have a band and a place to anchor it, I would say go ahead with that. We're going to do sets of maybe 8 to 10 to start off with. So again, get yourself set. We're going to grab the band. We're going to exhale. Kind of push our pelvis back. Flatten our low back. Pull the band. And here we go. One quick note with any variation of that dead bug, you can always adjust how far you bring your leg down towards the floor. So if bringing it all the way down, and it's hard for you, makes it hard for you to keep your low back from arching and losing those abs in front and feeling an uncomfortable sensation in the back, just bring it down to a point where can maintain that low back into the floor. All right? probably weeks back. It's called a tripod transition. So we're going to go from this position here to this position here, that bear position. Knees just off the ground, pushing your hands away from the ground. So we're going to do five to each direction to complete the set. So again, we're just going to start like so. One leg straight, one arm up nice and tall at the shoulders. Straight leg is just going to thread through the other one until we come to this point, and then smoothly back. So that's one, we're going to do four more, then switch sides. Hopefully you can see me from this angle. Thing. One of my favorite exercises for strengthening, stability, as well as a little bit of mobility. We're going to do our yoga push-ups. So let's do, shoot for a minimum of five, maybe you're going up to eight or so. So remember, start in that plank position. Nice strong push-up. Push away. Hips towards the ceiling. Drop the heels down and repeat. again, as we've talked about, make sure you're using your breathing. You're not holding your breath. So as you reach, eyes follow that top hand. Maybe start with a nice big inhale. And then exhale as you let your body settle. And just repeat that with each rep. Again, we're going to go to those, we call it a tripod transition. So up nice and tall, think about pushing away from the floor with that straight arm, that hand with the straight arm, rather. And then we're just going to pivot here and then back. Keeping that brace position, make sure you're breathing. Pushing away from the floor. All right, And as far as the push-up goes, go as far as you can control. It doesn't have to be all the way down like I'm doing, but just do your best to go through the fullest range of motion that you can. We've got a little mobility that fits fine, being able to rotate properly. So again, you have your ball, foam roller, pillows, whatever it is. Top leg, make sure that knee and hip is bent. Bottom arm will support it there. Eyes on that top hand. And take a nice deep breath in. And then as I settle back, exhale. And try to get your arm and shoulder blades as close to the ground as you can without forcing it. We'll do 8 per side. Switch sides. Get on this side. Circuit one more time. So dead bug is next. 8 to 10 reps, or even less, 5 or 6. Again, do as many as you can with keeping that good form. Once you're unable to keep that lower back from arching excessively, you keep that front side really engaged. Take a break, reset, or just stop the set right there. Either way, it's going to be our last set of these. So exhale, tilt that pelvis back, gently push the low back into the floor, and go. Final set of those transitions. And actually, you know what? I find these work a little bit better without the shoes on. Get yourself set. Again, keep enough of a brace around that spine so you're really not excessively moving through the spine, but just enough so you can still breathe and move. Downward facing dog. circuit. Hopefully make you feel a little bit better, move a little bit better, maybe disrupt your day a little bit, get you away from either sitting in front of a computer or whatever job you do, get you away from whatever postures you tend to be in. So hope you liked it. Again, comments are always welcome. So let us know how you are enjoying this, if there's something else you want to see. This will be on YouTube later. If you haven't already, please subscribe. We always appreciate that. Or, you know, if you think it's good content, share it with your friends and family, have them subscribe. We're looking to build out more and more, but we would definitely like your feedback on it. We want to make sure what we're doing is helpful, it's useful. We're just going to continue to grow and hopefully give you guys more and more value. Have an awesome day. It's Thursday, so I will see you guys.